So, all right, Lucky versus Silent Wolf. I don't think we're going to get a button check. Yeah, everyone's warmed up right now. There's no point.
They've been 20XXing all over the place. So.
Yeah.
So, what about... You play Otto a lot, so yeah. Tell me about his playstyle.
He's like fiction. He's got a lot of, like, little tricks that, like... He was... I pointed out one earlier. He will, The way he almost brought this match back versus SFAT earlier... he tried to get a shine spike there. He basically got, like, a back throw at the ledge, and he didn't outright gimp him, but he got, like, 70 damage in his edge guard, like, back air, like catching his jump, back airing him, like, and continuing this little setup he had that he kind of just had an answer for everything SFAT tried to do.
And I feel like Otto and Hax and Fiction, all, those players who do the same thing over and over again, it was the best option.
Yeah.
And, like, players like Zach would be kind of bored and, like, try something else. So, like,
Cold Ball, Lucky, yeah, they're a little more, like, intuitive, whereas Hax, Silent Wolf, Fiction are more cerebral. And I mean, not to pigeonhole them, because like, obviously there's a lot of reading involved. Like that up smash, you don't just run into the corner and up smash, you know, unless you have a pretty good idea that it's going to hit, so. Oh, interesting. Alright, I don't think I've ever seen Silent Wolf and Lucky play in tournament, like ever.
I don't know.
Oh, you know what? I'm wrong. They played at Pound 4. So that was the last time, though. So 2010.
Yeah.
Back. Yeah, so it's been a cool minute. It's been 4 years. Coming up on 5. Dude, what? Pound 4 was hella long ago.
Yeah, my first national was in January of 2005. And, like...
We're getting there. Yeah. We're getting to that 10-year mark, that double digits. Dude, that's nuts. This is super close right now. Ooh, runs up and grabs. All right, Lucky trying to make something happen off this. See, it seems like Lucky, a lot of the time, he ends combos kind of early because he's going for these like reads and stuff. And if he doesn't get them,
he gets punished for it.
He could get punished for it, yeah. But he's got a really, really good like idea of when to do what. So more often than not, he gets his read. Mango's kind of the same way. He's that, you know, that kind of... If you want to contrast like Mango and like Pee Pee, for example, I think it's kind of a similar thing going on. Ooh,
that was chapter one.
Yeah, in the beginning, there was the shine. All right. Oh my God. That was brutal.
He shined him and then jumped and neared him before he the shine knocked him away.
That's what it looked like, dude. I swear I saw like a tech or something. So like maybe auto teched it in place and then the nair hit him or something. I'd have to go back and watch. Ooh, that was good. Up till, didn't quite get the follow-up. I think he was going for a read of some sort. All right, this could be... All right, Lucky's making it back. Silent with, like, all the stage control right now.
He's trying to keep him... He's trying to turn Yancey and put Baby in the corner.
Yeah, oh my God. Okay, Lucky tried to swag a little bit. He almost got that that wall jump shine, which is actually, like, a pretty...
It's kind of hard to do on Battlefield, right?
It's yeah, you can't, like, stages like FD, you could technically get that, like, Daraki wall jump thing, so you don't use your double jump. And Battlefield, of course, has got such a tiny lip that it's you got a small, like, kind of margin to do it. The cool thing is, you are invincible for, like, a couple, like, I don't know the frame count.
15
but it's, like,
frames?
15, yeah, like, a pretty sizable amount of time.
That's a quarter of a second. That's, like, in this game, that's a lot.
You can reach them with the shine and be fine. Like, the fire won't burn you.
Yeah.
But of course, the problem is if you miss your gimp, you're out of a jump. Yeah. So, uh-oh. That's it. Oh, and he actually... Dude, smash the eye. All right. Oh, I like that choice.
You have to get a lot of Fox Force actually don't use their down tilt a lot.
Dude, I actually agree with you. I was playing Flash a lot this week because I'm housing him, and he was telling me, like, dude, you use down tilt more than a lot of Foxes, and I think it's really good. Because it's a launcher that pops them up not too high that you can do very easily off of crouch cancel. That's significant.
And it's got great range. Like, and it pokes in her shields for characters like Sheik and Peach who shields them cover their feet.
Yeah, for sure. Ooh, Lucky right now is getting kind of bopped. All right, Silent Wolf might get a pretty good win here on Lucky if he just keeps his momentum up. Dude, the thing about down tilt too that's cool is because you can crouch cancel into it, sometimes like they'll hit you with a move, but it is such range that if you crouch, you slide back from the crouch cancel, you can still reach them with the down tilt.
Yeah.
Really, really strong versus like another Fox's Nair, for example. Okay, Lucky is trying to pull this back. Just misses that grab. Ooh, this could be... Ooh. Asylum right now is... Ooh, I like that read a lot.
Yeah, he knew he wouldn't go back to the center stage, so...
Yeah, he hadn't been to the center in a cool minute. He was like, I gotta get out of here. I missed the center. It was nice over there. Ooh, oh, Joey!
That was a delicious deck, though.
That was crazy. All right, I really like that play from Lucky. He's got some momentum right now. Let's see if he can, like, work with it. Uh-oh.
See, all the foxes that I know, they would have been falling up there.
Right. All right, getting a little ambitious with that forward smash, but this is dead even right now. Yeah. He's waiting for the sidestep.
Oh, poor Otto.
Oh, dude. And he had a pretty, like, easy 2-0 in the bag, and he is...
struggling.
Yeah.
Oh. Huh. I like that.
I was thinking up smash. I would up smash. Was that what you were thinking?
I was thinking that, too, but I did like the down smash choice.
Okay.
I feel like
down, you've got, like, a little special place in your heart for down smash.
I do.
Okay.
Falco has that weird hitbox in his down smash in the middle that's in the, like, straight up. Does Fox have that as well?
He does, yeah. Well, but you don't go straight up. It's just a weaker hit.
Okay.
All right. So Lucky wins that, actually. Crazy comeback. Yeah, it's a weaker hit. It sends the... I don't know if you remember, there's this video on YouTube called Silent Spectre Impossible DI.
Okay.
And he survives a down smash at, like, 160. He barely goes anywhere. That was the inner hit of the down smash.
Gotcha.
It's not as good as Falco's. But it will still set up for an edgeguard. All right.
It's Fox. Isn't everything set up for an edgeguard?
Basically, yeah.
This is the first time we've seen FD in a while.
Dude, it is. Ooh, Silent Wolf is feeling it. Because, like, I know a lot of the time he doesn't like this stage because the chain grabs, but...
Well, I was thinking just because, like, he is more of, like, a textbook methodical player, he would prefer the chain grabs.
One would think that, yeah, but the way he describes it, it's like a lot of the times he says, I feel like I'll only lose if I get chain grabbed. Yeah.
Yeah, and it's kind of like an evener, like.
Yeah. And, oh, that was a beautiful angle. And that's
like a Meech King angle.
Yeah.
Nice. That's all she wrote.
That is all she wrote in that book that she was writing in. Let's go. Dude, the interesting thing, too, is... Oh, I like that. Every time I try to say something, something happens. But SFAT actually always counterpicks the stage on Silent Wolf. So...
How does their sets usually go?
Back and forth. Pretty 50-50. I think SFAT won the last time they played, but... They've been trading sets.
I get to see any of these foxes pick FOD.
That's not really, like, a fox stage.
Yeah, but I feel like there's a couple foxes... who do really well on stage. Chillin actually does great on stage. And I feel like if you're that kind of fox player, that can be to your advantage.
If you like the stage, yeah, I agree with you. You know, one fox that always counterpicks that stage, actually, even at Ditto's, is Unknown.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, hashtag free him, but, you know. Like, when he played, he would always go that stage, even in matchups where you wouldn't expect him to.
Do you remember Fast Like Tree?
I do.
He used to counterpick foxes to Brinstar in the Ditto.
Oh, what the? I mean, if it's a Ditto, it
can
work.
He knew the stage better than them, and so...
Yeah, I wouldn't feel comfortable playing on that stage. So, anything to get, like, a little edge over your opponent, I guess. Ooh, Lucky with the call out. A full jump, okay. Nice. All right, one grab will even this up, but that's the thing about this stage. Like, the stock count is kind of the only thing that matters. Like, the percents almost, in a way, kind of don't.
Yeah, especially because Fox can punish himself so well.
Yeah.
Especially on FD with no platforms.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
And off a knockdown.
Yeah. Oh, he tried to get that grab. Oh, this is potentially big.
Oh,
he should have... Oh, what the? He had an invincibility from the... Man, Lucky is cooking right now.
Sakurai!
Oh, yeah. Oh! And Otto loses to Lucky. Man, Silent Wolf has, like... That's, like, the second or third set I've seen where Silent Wolf, like, had it and then kind of just dropped
it. Was up in game two?
Yeah. Yeah. He...